guys, thanks for joining us, and apologies for the slightly false start there. We had a little technical difficulty that I had to sort out. Pixie B was late.
I wasn't. Honestly.
No, she wasn't. No, totally my bad. Totally my bad. So, welcome to the Mum's Makery. What month are we in?
April.
April craft,
I think. I'm sure April.
As you know, we changed the day. Yeah, we were supposed to do the Crafternoon yesterday, but obviously, out of respect, we moved the day to Sunday instead. However, the Pixies have all been out on a Pixie excursion this morning, so they've only all just got back. But more on that later. So, welcome to our April Crafternoon. And today we are focusing on blending wool and two-toning to get sort of nice sort of graded effects. And there's lots of different ways that you can achieve the same result. If some of you saw us at the Needle Felt in UK Festival, then we made fluffs, and that video is also on our YouTube channel. And have a look at that, because we reverse needle felted, and that's a really nice sort of two-tone blending technique as well. Particularly, can't get my words out now, specifically. Particularly if you are doing sort of 3D models, you know, animals and things like that. So I will bring your attention to the festival mug. We're at the Crafternoon.
We are.
Grab up the cup there, but do be careful. Have a look in there, because the cup, Sarah, if you're watching, your cup's got a chip in it, mate. I think Sarah Brown is not with us today. She's the lovely lady who runs the original Needle Felting UK group. So do go over and join that group if you're not part of it already. But yeah.
Very cute.
Yeah.
Adorable.
Yeah.
Shall I put the chip back in the cup?
Yeah, you can put the chip.
Thank you.
Serious Leak, for those of you who remembered the last Crafternoon, Serious Leak has sparked a whole range of silly veg. But we will get to that a little bit later on in the broadcast. So, hello to everybody. We should be coming live to you across YouTube and Facebook. Each live chat, so there's a live chat on Facebook and there is a live chat on YouTube, is manned by one of our lovely Pixies. In YouTube, you have Pixie Hayley Belsham. And on Facebook, you have Pixie Nikki Preston. I always...
I know, sorry, it's Nikki. Hard to say.
And then one of our crew members, Sarah Summerton, will be flitting about between both chats and providing you guys with links and stuff. So, without further ado, there is a few dates that I'll quickly run through. I tend to waffle at the beginning of the broadcast just to let everybody sort of get logged in and catch up with us. So we've got a few dates for your diary. The first day is the next Crafternoon, which will be on the 15th of May. So that's Saturday the 15th of May, same time, 3 p.m. And coming up next, we've got our May live launch. We only do one or two live launches a year, but do come and join us for that. It's not a Crafternoon, it's not an event. It is simply we are launching some stuff on the website, and we thought that we would have fun with you and do it live. And finally, also a busy month, May.
It is.
And also in May, we are going back to the craft store, which was formerly known as Hochanda. It's still known as Hochanda, actually, but now it's the craft store by Hochanda. And we will be on the craft store, and that will be at 10 a.m. on the 29th of May. Wrong camera.
Which is lovely.
There you go, Sam. Push the right button.
You're distracted by the biscuits.
It is. We've got check out the biscuits. But Pete has not disappointed people.
They are very nice.
This is his one job. to provide the confectionery. So, what is it? We've had all sorts, haven't we? We had, what did we have last time? Crispy crumbs.
And flat crack.
Crispy crumbs.
And donuts.
Yeah. So we will be...
All of it.
just feast your eyes. I know a lot of you join us with snacks, so, okay.
Don't blame them.
Right. So, what we're going to... We're trying something different.
Uh-oh.
So, it all could go horribly wrong. I've no idea.
I hope not.
But do stay tuned because we do have a surprise for you in this next hour. That's all we're going to say about that. So today we are focusing on two-toning and blending. And what I'm going to do is, or what we're going to do, is quickly run through the sort of the different methods that you can use for hand blending right through to, you know, all different types of blending. So I'm just going to pop my, whatever that was, I'm going to put it over there.
Felting mat.
That's the one. This is what happened to me. I had one broadcast unsupervised.
I know. That made me ever so nervous. I sat at home thinking, please don't say anything bad, please.
That was not me. What am I doing? Right, okay, so what we're going to do...
is some blending.
Let's go with those two because they're very, very different. So what I've got are hot pink and candy floss. And this will give you a nice sort of idea of the colours. Well, let's put it on the overhead camera. So you can see there's the candy floss and there's the hot pink. And the first thing that I want to do is I want to show you hand blending. And in a pinch, this is by far the easiest way to really blend. I'm not going to use weights and measures, but we'll be working on an approximate 50-50 split just for ease. So when you hand blend, oh, my tube's gone off. So when you hand blend, what you're gonna have your two colours. You might have three colours. You could have as many colours as you like, really. But we want that camera. There we go. So to hand blend, you stack your fibres on top of each other and you pull and you stack and you pull and you stack. And that's it. It's pull and stack, pull and stack, pull and stack. You can rotate it through 90 degrees, but what you're looking at doing is breaking up those blocks of colour. Now, this is particularly good if you want, a choppier colour. Hand blend or fine hand blending takes time, lots and lots of time. But you can see that we're starting to get that blend. So it is just pull and stack. You're happy there, sat there just drinking your coffee and, you know, nicking the biscuits.
Yeah, I'm having a nice time, thank you.
You just sat here to watch me work for a change. So we're just going to pull and stack. Pull and stack, pull and stack. And you can see that we are, what was that? A minute or two of blending. We've still got some blocks of colour, but nah. And you can see that we've got just a reasonable rough blend. So I'm going to...
But for variation and petals, though, that's really good.
Yeah, if you want some very definitive colour changes in things like pretty. Petals, then that's, a rough hand blend. And you can do smaller quantities just for little bits. So the next thing that I'm going to do... Oh, thanks.
Thanks. Look after them.
Is it because I just dropped the other one on the floor?
No, of course not. No, I'm going to be helpful.
I feel like I'm being supervised. Right. So, the next thing...
Off to go and rogue last time? Yes, you need it.
Oh! She's getting really topsy now. She is. She was all sweet and lovely on the first broadcast. Now she's giving me jip.
Well, you're giving me a microphone.
It was...
I've got to get you back.
Okay, so for the next stage up, dog brushes. These are these types of dog brush. I don't know what specifically they are called.
You don't want the ones with the bobbles on the end.
No, you yeah.
You've got to look for them.
Yeah, you don't want the ones that have got like the little plasticky bobbles yeah. on the end. You want you want these wire ones. And what we're gonna do with the dog brushes is we're just gonna pull off a little bit of fibre, and the way that I do this is just let the brush take what it wants. Don't try to hold on and pull the fibres. So I put about half of what I had on there, and obviously the size of brush will somewhat dictate how much fluff you can put on there. So then what I'm going to do is just pull off a little bit more of the hot pink. See, I've got about half of what I started with. Now, dog brushes and hand carders, the technique is the same. Don't sort of drag like that. It's this action.
It's more rocking.
It is. In fact, I'll move the biscuits further away from... so, wrong camera. There we go. So, where are we? There. Hang on.
You move them further away from me.
Once bitten me, I never put the cakes near you anymore. So what we're going to do is it's this kind of action. Don't try to pull straight out like that. And you just start mixing it up. You can see there. Pop it back on the brush. And I work this brush up and down this way as well as that way, and then it just picks up all kinds of bits. And you can see that in just a couple of passes, we've got the same.
Yeah.
In fact,
you've got a better blend.
You've got more of a blend. And, you know, dog brushes are a really, really sort of cheap way of being able to blend. I mean, all right, you don't want to be blending up 50 grams on dog brushes. That'd give you a bit of an armache.
Yeah.
Although I have done that. So I'm going to go...
It actually blends it really well.
It does, yeah. So there, that's, what, four or five passes. And look at that blend there. That's lovely. So... there's our hand blend, and there's our dog brush blend. So next up, my glamorous assistant.
Big carders.
Big
carders.
Big carders. You wait, I'm going to smack the camera now.
Everyone,
keep
stand
brace
back.
Yourself, people. It's going to get rough. I'm going to move myself like a great big area.
Is your mic working properly?
Huh?
Is your mic working properly?
Is my mic working? Yes. Why?
Okay. I just wondered.
Why?
Because apparently I'm louder.
Is you?
And that never happens. Never, ever, ever.
I've got a feeling that the gain on... I'll sort it out in a minute. So Ross, if you're watching, when I say I'm going to sort out my mic, turn the volume down. I blew her ears off last time.
Poor thing.
When I record the tutorials, I turn the gain down on the microphone when I'm doing when I'm recording.
Okay.
But for broadcasts, I turn it up and I turn it down on the software. But I've forgotten to turn my mic back
okay.
up.
Okay. Fair enough then.
Bit of technical waffle for you. Not that anybody's interested. So, again, what I'm going to do is you can see that. Do you want to shift that? Thank you. I need lots and lots of space.
Yes.
So again, like the dog brush, or the dog brushes, same principle. I'm just dragging off. just let the you know, let it sort of catch whatever it wants. I think that will do. And then again, we're going to do that rocking action. So it's that. If you try and
it's not going to work.
It's like
it's jammed.
Yeah. So that rocking action, and you can see. And the hand carders are absolutely no different to the dog brushes. They just do more.
I was going to say, that's just a bigger amount.
Yeah. There is a thing called a blending board, which I used to have. She nicked it. And she's like, this is my not bothered face. And so you can blend, but that's more for the spinning thing. Yeah.
Yes, yeah, it's very good
because
for spinning.
Because you pull it off in Rolags or something,
yes.
Don't you?
Yep.
And then you
tubes of fibre.
She spins. I do. We're down on that camera.
Yeah, we do. It's fun.
She spins. I don't. The only thing I spin on is my office chair.
So, backpuss colours, that's what they've said they are.
Hmm?
They're the colours of backpuss.
Yes. Yes, we are carding
backpuss.
I don't know if we can say it though, because it's a carrot.
Why?
Can we? I don't know. We're carding backpuss.
Well, it's similar.
Yes. That's what we could call this blend.
That's
so there,
pretty.
You can get back on the close-up camera. So there's my blend with, obviously it's about the same as the dog brushes.
I'd say so,
but it took me a little bit longer because there's more
fiber.
Yeah. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put these little piles. Actually, I can give you a close-up of all three now.
Mm-hmm.
Let me just pop those down. I feel we're being very clattery at the moment. So there's the hand blend. There's the dog brush with sort of, what was that, five passes.
Mm-hmm.
And there's the brushes.
Yep.
With the carding brushes. So three ways to get a few different sort of techniques. She's gone!
She escaped.
She escaped.
Yeah.
Nice try, mate. So the other thing that I want to sort of talk to you guys about is cleaning. Because if you're doing white and then you're doing red and then you're doing green, you don't want you don't want cross contamination with your fibres. So this thing is an absolute diamond.
Mm.
And let me pop it on the close up camera a minute. This is for cleaning out a hairbrush. And it's got these absolutely amazing ends. Now, I will put a link in the Facebook group. I know the Pixies don't have links for this at the moment. This was a bit of a last minute addition. But this will really clear out. You've got these bigger ones this end, and then this end, they're sort of denser. You can see there and there. So you've got a really, really good cleaning brush. And like I said, I will get the link for this. Where did we get this? Was it Amazon? It might have been Amazon.
It's either Amazon or eBay.
Yeah.
And if you just put in hairbrush cleaner,
you can look it up yourself, but I really, really recommend this one for sort of cleaning out your brushes and whatnot. So we've covered hand blending. We've covered brushes, sort of dog brushes, and we've covered hand carders, as in the large ones. My my hand carders are Howard hand carders, and they are, I think I paid about £45 for these. The dog brushes will cost you maybe £5 or £6 each.
They're also a lot lighter for someone like me whose hands hurt.
That's a really good point. If you are somebody who has some dexterity issues, go with the the dog brushes, because they're a lot lighter to use. Those hand carders do weigh, they are quite weighty. So we've done hand blending, we've done brush blending, we've done hand carder blendings, and now we're going to go over to Pixie B in Studio B for B Cam.
Hello. Now who's rogue?
I'm going to fix my microphone whilst you discuss the benefits of carders.
I am going to tell everyone about this amazing drum carder here, which is my favourite thing. This is the little baby. This is the granddaddy.
This is the one. That's the this one. This is the one. On.
Yes, this is what's used. This is, you know, personal sort of thing for spinning, and I'm going to show you how easy this is. So we have pumpkin and bright yellow. And what we are going to do is, I like to separate the fibre. And if you watch with this lovely Mum's Makery fibre, you can pull it off so it's cobweb thin. And that is the best thing to do with the drum carder. Keep it really thin and fine and see-through. That's just going to be the best thing ever. And then you pop it on. You turn the handle. That's it. It is that easy. So I'm going to take a bit of the pumpkin. Let's see how quickly we can get this blended. And again, just, you know, you want to be able to see through it.
Because if it's my too microphone. Thick,
oh no, have you? That means everyone will hear people. You now. And basically, to blend, what we're going to do, it's just alternate the colours. In this case, bright yellow and pumpkin. I'm just going to do a little bit.
Turn the cards around so they can see the bit that's feeding in, maybe. Yeah, that's perfect.
Yep. Is that okay?
Yeah, perfect.
Say, what we do for you people. Makes it more difficult for me, mind you, but that's absolutely fine. That's fine. So, this is called your liquor in brush, and this is your main
drum. Now?
Liquor in brush, and what you don't want is for your fibre to be on this little brush. Little brush, let's call it that then, shall
we? Okay, the little roller.
Yes, okay. The little roller. And what it does is it sucks the fibre in underneath.
There's some quality comedy to be had with that.
Behave yourself.
Okay.
So the fibre is fed in, and the little brush feeds it and deposits it on the big brush. So basically, this is all you need to do for this. It's really, really easy. And you just keep going round and round and round. That's it. Nice and easy.
I like this bee cam because I can sit over and eat biscuits.
I sincerely hope not. Okay, few tools of the trade that I like to use with my drum carder. Obviously, you get your doffer brush, which is for taking the fibre off the drum. Doffer tool.
Okay.
Sharp pointy tool that usually comes with a cork on the end so you can't hurt anyone with
it. Which she usually threatens me with.
I also have a porcupine quill, which is really good for picking out little tiny bits of fibre that get stuck on here. Usually I use the hairbrush cleaner, but I don't have it because someone nicked it.
Catch!
No. And I have a long skinny hairbrush. And this I find, I have a brush on the back that helps to pack the fibre onto the drum. I find this one better, to be honest, at just compacting the fibre just a couple of times. And then comes the fun. We're going to take the fibre off. And I like to use the back of the carder to actually help the fibre come off. And here we have first pass on the drum carder. And as you can probably see, if I pull this apart, you can actually see all the layers
that, real well. That it's you've really nice and layery.
Yeah, that you've put on. So to blend it is the great thing, okay? Now you get the fun bit. You get to rip the thing up into little bits. And then again, tease this apart. You want it to be see-through. And put it back through the drum. I'm going to put my brush back on the back. And I know it's not on there because it's then silent. And this is literally all you do.
Ashley suggested that we call that colour Be Sunset.
Ah, oh, that's so nice. I like that. I like you people. You're nice.
They're nice to you.
Of course, because I'm a nice person.
Nikki's suggesting that we have a carder party.
And then, good God, that'll be fun. I like the sounds of that. The other thing I find with using the hairbrush cleaner is if you've got just a very small amount of fibre on the drum, this is actually really good at pulling the whole lot off in one go. And literally, if you've got teeny tiny bit of fibre, you don't have to fill the thing to maximum. This is only a little carder and it only does about 20 grams anyway. But this will then pull off all your fibre. And that is second blend.
Nice.
She's there with biscuit and coffee while I'm working. How mean. Right. Should we pop some more through?
Yes. So this will be a third pass.
Yep. I'm going to leave that little stripy bit there.
Yep, perfect.
And then I'm going to pop this lot through. Again, tear it up, tease it out. You have to be able to see through it. If you put too much on the drum carder, you will jam it. And it will be very grumpy with you.
So the little drum carder that Bee's using at the moment, that one takes about, 20 grams?
You can squeeze 30 on it if you use the hairbrush to really, really pack the fibre on.
Okay.
This beauty hair will do about five times that.
Yeah, that one we usually put, what, do about up to 150?
Yes.
That big... the big carder that you see in the background there, all of our carders are classic carders. We've got a small one, a medium-sized one, and then the one that you see in the background is called a jumbo wide.
Which is fab.
Mainly because when we're doing the blends, and whilst you're doing that, I'll just bring people back over here a minute, because I've got a few blends to show you. As you know, some of our kits... we have lots of blends and colours that we do specifically for our kits. This one is the hydrangea blend. And let me get my, where you can see that this one in terms of a blend is really quite choppy. It's not a fine blend at all, because then when you create those sort of little petals, you know, it really hits it with the colour. You can see the hydrangeas in the background. We've got all this back here is using some kind of two-toning or blending. So what I've also got is our sunflower blend. And again, this is this is the sunflower yellow. And then we've also got the sunflower green. So those are just a few blends that we actually make. The sunflower yellow and green is available actually in the shop. So she's back.
I'm back. As if by magic.
Pixie magic.
First.
So we'll get this on the on ye olde close up. So you can see that you've got, this is pass number one for the card, and you can see you've really got some stripes there. And then pass number two. Pass me. You're trying to get to the biscuits, aren't you? You're not paying attention.
Wow.
So there's pass number two, and you can see that we've, you know, just two passes gets you a really, really nice blend. And then pass number three, again, really quite blended. I would say that there's not much more difference between two and three passes than there's a lot more difference between a single pass and another, and pass number two, than there is between two and three.
Yeah, because it's becoming more and more blended and integrated.
So, you know, you definitely get more bang for your buck going for two passes. Mm-hmm. But then it's, you can go on ad infinitum. You can blend a couple of colours, sort of, you know, twice, and then add in a third colour. So the third colour would be a lot more chopsy in, you know, threads. So if you wanted this colour nice and blended, you'd put this through twice. Then you could add in, I don't know, a different colour, maybe a bright red or something, and blend that through once. These colours would be nice and blended, and then you get those real sort of points where they hit it with the bright red. So I'm now, well, we are now.
Oh, Pixie use. Nikki said it looks like bonfire.
Yeah,
it does. It does actually. That's,
you wait, next nice. they'll want us to make it and stock it, and you have to be careful what you do in front of the Pixies, to be fair.
My arm.
Yeah. Think of Bee's arm.
Exactly.
Hayley. Who just wants everything blended all the time. Oh, bless her. Right.
It is a beautiful colour, though.
Let me just pop that down.
It has
there
come out very well. It's like
it has,
flamed.
Yeah. That's what we should call it.
Flames.
So what I'm going to do now is we're going to use a couple of templates. And I've got some greens. Where are we? Do you want an, have an ivy leaf?
Oh, thank you.
That's all right.
How nice. I'm going to use
the pink that I blended on the card of brushes. Do you want to use some of your?
I think I
realise that you're doing a leaf, but this is
autumn. Just saying.
Yeah, autumn's just, we're already thinking of autumn. We're done with Christmas now. We're into autumn. Speaking of autumn, I did say that I was going to give a little mention to the Pixie outing that happened mm-hmm. this morning.
Yes.
And it was, obviously we've got, you guys know, we have the Makery Pixies, and we have a group crew as well in the Facebook group. And I thought that it would be a nice idea to send them all away.
We had a lovely time.
And just so saying. The Pixie bus left the Makery this morning. No. Basically, what I did was I paid for them all to go on a course with the Lady Moth. And we absolutely love the Lady Moth. And Nikki and Sarah and Hayley will put links in your relevant chats to her Facebook page. She does just the most amazing little courses and workshops. And she's such a phenomenal teacher. And do you want to show them what you made? This is what they made on their little workshop this morning. It was a custom workshop for mm-hmm. them. It was just the Pixies and crew, and did it on Zoom, didn't you?
We did. It was amazing.
She is an absolutely amazing teacher.
She's very, very good.
And it was three and a half hours?
3 hours,
like that.
Yeah, just
so,
over.
You know, that is, and actually let me put it on, no, wrong camera. There you go. Go for that one.
This one here.
You want me to move the mug?
It's fine.
Look at that. Did a really good job there, mate.
Thank you. I don't get much chance for any felting. No. It was a real treat, let me tell you.
Start a felting business, never felt again.
Absolutely. No, it was lovely.
Yeah, that is an absolute, it's a beautiful mate. So we will,
I'll
get the Pixies and stuff to put up or to send me pictures of what they make, and I'll pop them up in group. But yeah, it is just, we all had a fun morning. Mm. I did pop in the Zoom meet and just caused havoc and then left.
Yes.
Because I had to prep for this. But they all seemed like you were having a nice time.
We did, yeah. And had a lovely
like
time.
I said, just an amazing teacher. She's absolutely ace.
She is very good.
So what I'm going to do, have we done...
Can I just say something?
Okay.
I get given the really awkward shape, you know, with points and all of it. Just saying.
You saw that, huh?
Just saying.
Never miss a trick. Right, we've done all the... I've got my notebook.
Trusty notebook.
Down here. Should we tell them about the giveaway?
Yes, please.
I'm not going to be showing you how to fill templates. This is all just about sort of blending and two-tone. So all I'm going to do is just start putting some fibres down. I will be using my 40 spiral needle, my light needle. And I'm using the blend that I blended on the hand carders. And I'm not fussy picking or anything like that. I am just pulling some bits off. I'm not even doing weights and measures. So while she's doing all the hard work, I'm just going to waffle to you. What we thought, the Pixies keep getting banned off Facebook, which is hilarious. And it's every time we do a giveaway, and they have to number all of the entries. So Facebook thinks they're spamming.
Mm-hmm.
So they get put on the naughty step by Facebook.
And then they can't work.
And then Hayley, I think Hayley got put in timeout for about 4 hours or something. And it's utterly hilarious as that is. Obviously, it's not something that we want to happen. So I had to look for a different way of handling the giveaways. Now, as you know, we usually put up a thing in group, and it's sort of like, you know, tell us your favourite, you know, pet's name, or, you know, caption the image and all these kinds of things. So what we're going to do now is this broadcast, this little Crafternoon is going to be, you're all going to be our test guinea pigs.
So
what? Yeah. So what the Pixies are going to do is, in the live chats, they're going to put you up a link to the April Crafternoon giveaway.
Mm-hmm.
And this is only going to be for people who watch this broadcast today, because what we will do at some point late this evening is I will do the random draw for it. Now, it won't be like we do them before with Google. This little sort of add-on to my website does all of the drawing for me. I don't know if it emails you if you win. We are testing this out. So what they'll do is they'll put a little link in the group, and they will also put a little link in chat. And it's mumsmakery.co.uk/pages/April-crafternoon-giveaway.
I am really impressed that you remember that.
It's there.
Oh, is it? Nikki's put it up already. Well done, Nikki.
Nice one, Nikki. Thank
She's
you.
She's on the ball.
I thought I broke a needle then. I was like, oh my God, that just like never happens. Anyway, I'm just like...
You will do now.
I'll break a whole army of them now. I'm going to catch... You're doing yours really quick. I feel like I need to catch up. So, in theory... All you need to do to enter that giveaway is go to that page and put in your email address. Allegedly. It could all go horribly wrong. We have no idea. We've tried, we've sort of tested it out with the Pixies.
And did that go well?
Not really, no.
Oh.
But what we're going to do is, shall we show them what we're going to give away? Because we are doing blending and two-toning, what Pixie B has done is she's made a custom ombre blend of yellow. And there's a little bonus.
It had to be yellow because it's my favourite colour.
It is your favourite colour.
It is.
Look, you even get a, what is it? Is it a key ring?
Yeah. Or a stitch marker, something like that. Anything.
So you even get this little beaded bee.
That I did last night.
From Pixie Bee.
I stayed up till midnight for you guys. I did. Because they're awesome.
So there you go. You get... five colours, a lovely yellow ombre, which is completely custom because we don't do that, and
it is beautiful.
So that's the giveaway prize that you're going to be winning, unless one of the pixies nab it and run off.
They're not allowed. Nope.
So I'm really behind here.
Made on little tiny drum carder.
Was it made on the little one, was it?
It was, yes.
There you go.
Makes beautiful little bats.
Yeah, we outgrew it pretty quick.
Yes.
And then she didn't like the other carder that I got her.
It's not that I didn't like it. It didn't make pretty bats.
It didn't make pretty bats.
You guys deserve pretty bad. That's all I'm going to say.
I can't even remember where we got it from. I think it was Etsy or something like that. We bought a larger carder. Mm. I've got a classic carder, which is the sort of the standard high. It's a high one, so that you can use it on a table. but we had... I motorised it. I motorised it because it just hurts. It hurts my arm. So I motorised my carder. But you didn't like the motorised one, did you? No. So I had
like
that
the
back
noise.
And I had to get her another one.
I'm a bit sensitive to noise and it was... Ooh.
Yeah.
Just couldn't.
So I got her another one. Bigger one, so she can make bigger bats and do more work. And then I perhaps maybe sort of inquired as to why productivity had not increased. And she's still using the little one. I'm like, but why are you using the little one? She said, I don't like the other card. It doesn't make pretty bats. Really?
Okay. It's important.
It is. I reckon she was just holding out for a jumbo. Why? That's what it was.
You know the next thing.
No.
I think they do a motorised version of that themselves.
But you don't like the motorised ones. They're too noisy.
But we might be able to put a silencer on it.
It's not a weapon.
Oh, I don't know. Those spikes are very sharp.
You know, there was a simple solution to that problem. Earmuffs. I'm just saying.
I earmuffs can still are hear a it. Thing. Even with headphones on.
Silencing earmuffs. I vote earmuffs. So I'm going to pop you back on the close-up cat, and you can see that's just from the hand blend. You can see that there's just some beautiful variation. Now this is the side that I'm working on, and this is the side that's facing the flat mat. Of course, I'm working on my flat mat with my felt topper, and I always find that the side that faces the flat mat just comes out so well. I do feel like I'm not keeping up with my felting. I'm going to go for the clattering tool.
Oh no.
Hang on. I'm going to find the one that's got needles in it. Last time I started out. I was like, wow, this is just going really, really... Oh, wait, there's no needles in it. That's why.
That will do it.
Always make sure your clattering tool has needles.
Those are brilliant, those tools. I used that this morning, actually. Did you? On top of the mushroom, yeah.
You were the one that was clattering.
No, 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 my mic was on mute.
That's what you think.
It was.
I was unmuting people. I wasn't unmuting people.
So how many pictures did you take of us?
Oh, it was hilarious. Because I don't know if any of you guys have been on Zoom, but you all basically sit there and you've got little squares. And it looks like a really bad game of blankety blank.
It does.
I've got everybody's concentration face. So, you can see that it's fluffy because I'm not doing this particularly well, but that's the sort of thing that you've got. Do you want to give me yours?
Okay.
Thank you. And look at the Bee Blaze blend.
Mm-hmm. It does look like the most beautiful.
So that's bright yellow and pumpkin.
Pumpkin.
Was it bright yellow and pumpkin? Yeah. Think autumn, people. Think mm-hmm. sunsets.
Oh, beautiful.
Look at that.
That would be very nice as a background if you then do silhouetted animals
against it. Yeah, I was just thinking giraffe.
Mm. That would be really, really lovely.
My bookkeeper is a giraffe. Not, obviously she's not a giraffe, but she's her bookkeeping company's called Giraffe. That's why I chose her.
Oh, okay.
I asked Google. I was like, find a bookkeeper near me. And the first one just looked all corporate and boring, and the second one was giraffe. I was like,
oh,
that's
the one.
When I phoned her up, and she was like, oh, she said, if I can ask, she said, what made you pick me? I said, because you're called Giraffe. And you could always hear, or you could almost hear her voice just go, really?
Yep. Poor woman.
To go make her a giraffe head.
Oh.
Might freak her out, but
quite possibly
life size. Okay, so I'm just going to stop
this
that.
It really is a pretty blend.
It is, yeah.
I'm really liking this.
A wick.
Yeah, I don't want to be blending. It's okay. Personal use only.
I'm going to end up with one of them like big industrial carders that we're going to.
It will be really good because then I can move in.
Oh, because you can move. No, there won't be any room for you. I'm going to sit you underneath the carder. Put you a bunk under there or something. Right, so there's my... So that was just taken from this. What I need now is some
pretty.
Magenta. Which is over there.
Would you like me to get you
some? I would, thank you very much. I'll put this on the overhead camera for a minute. I'm using... this is the rose petal. Well, this was the free gift rose petal that we did. I don't remember when we did it, but we did it recently. And I'm using this just simply so that you can see a larger mass of what we're doing. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to tip my edge. No, you've got a leaf. I've got a petal.
Oh, okay. Rose petal.
I can tell, yes. I couldn't edge. The word edge just lost me. So what I'm going to do is you can see that I've got quite a thin sort of spread. Now, there's a couple of ways that you can do it. If you apply fluff on the top, then you want to make sure that you've got a nice lot of frizz. And grab your lightest needle and just jump about, because all we want to do at this particular junction is just, I want to make sure I've got some held down right at the very, very top. And the instinct, I think, is to just start felting. Now, what I'm going to say is don't do that. Turn the whole, oops, t- turn the whole thing over so that your fibre is on the bottom, and then felt through. And again, I'm stopping when I get to my flat mat. I'm not driving into my mat because I don't want these are all loose fibres on this side, and I don't want them embedding into my mat, but I do want them felting into my petal. So in actual fact, let me get my clattering tool back. Excuse the noise. And what you will see that will happen is that because you're felting from the back through to the front, you will get a much nicer sort of blend. If you were to just felt this colour on top, it would just stay on top, and you will end up with a block of colour. So let me show you my side. You can see I've got my colour like there. And I'm going to do a driving technique now and just really knock this back colour through and lift. You can see that it pushes, really pushes some of these lighter fibres through. I mean, you might not want that, so if you don't want that, then don't do the driving thing. Just put your, keep your petal in your template and go lightly. But I want to try and sort of show you a few different techniques. And then obviously, if you want to add more colours, look how that's beautifully blended into it now. So if you wanted to go from light to dark, then what I would suggest is always start with the lightest colour and work to dark. I tend to find that if you put dark fibres down first and then put the lighter fibres on, it dulls them. So start with the lightest and work to the darkest. And again, it's not a rule. There are exceptions to when you might want to do it dark to light. But again, there's no wrong way to do this. It's just about playing with your stash. I think I might have to make a few more of these petals now. They're coming out really nicely.
Oh, they're up so pretty. Mm.
So now what I'm going to do is go back to the front.
That's weird. Just saying.
Little light bounces, bouncing off the mat, coming through. There, and this is still quite fluffy, but there. You can really sort of see that blend. Don't know if the overhead camera is quite catching it quite as good as the close-up camera, but look, you've got that really dark. Now what you could do is maybe go in with an even darker colour and just really put it right on that edge. Frizz is your friend, so just a little bit of frizz. Again, felt through from the back. How are you getting on with your colours?
Not too bad.
And of course, the other thing you can do is if you've got a blend, what did I do? Candy floss and hot pink. And then you could always just sort of put a block of hot pink. So, you know, it's not a darker colour, it's the same colour, but it becomes more of a solid colour. I think hopefully that will make sense. So there's mine.
Can I have yours? There's one little bit I've done.
And you can see that they almost look flame tipped, don't they? Wow, it looks really, really nice. So again, just remember, felt through to the colour and sort of push your fibres through. Mm. If you were to put colour on top and felt it on top, then it just stays on top. And I think that was the biggest problem that I had when I started doing it, was I couldn't work out why there were these lovely blends that people were achieving and mine just looked like a block of colour. to turn it over and felt through from the back. If you're doing a 3D object, if you've got, you know, a rabbit or something like that, go and have a look at our fluffs tutorial, because we use the reverse needle felting technique. And that really does, we do it in two wacky colours, but you can see how you can achieve a really nice, beautiful blended coat to an animal. And I am pleased to say that the reverse needle felting needles will be on our website very, very soon.
Do you think you could use the reverse needles to help with the blending, to pull the colour through, and then use a normal needle
if
just to smooth it down?
It's a really good question. Yes and no. If it's something, because don't forget, something like this has, there's no substance to it.
No, this is
so
too thin.
I mean, try it. There's a reverse. Let me try it.
I just
it's all going to go wrong now. That's wrong side. That side. That's it. I mean, it's...
It does
It's sort of working.
Yeah.
But this is...
Okay.
But don't forget that a reverse needle is going to fluff it up, and you don't want fluffy. So you could use a reverse needle. I wouldn't on petals. I would turn it over and drive it out rather than trying to pull it out.
Fair enough.
Something to play with if anybody decides to give it a go. I find personally reverse needles are better on sort of more 3D objects where you can really, you know, get in there and pull the fibres out. So yeah, that's that.
Makes lovely.
So just going a couple of things to sort of touch base with you guys with. If you're not already familiar, then please do head over to our Facebook group. That's facebook.com/group/mumsmakery, because it's an amazing group, and they're all mental, to be fair. It is like a fluff asylum.
It is,
and the inmates are running it. Oh, is there?
Mm-hmm.
I can't actually read that. I don't know what you've...
Apparently there seems to be a little bit of a problem with people trying to enter the giveaway from YouTube.
Okay.
From Facebook, it's okay.
Go to...
So where would you like the pixies to post the link for them?
We can post it. I have no idea.
Because they need to be watching this.
It's Facebook. Yeah, it's facebook.com. No, it's not. Forget that. It's mumsmakery.co.uk/pages slash /April-crafternoon-giveaway. If you are on Facebook, message Pixie Nikki or Pixie Haley. Mm-hmm. They'll give you the link directly. If you're not, and you are watching this, because to be fair, the Crafternoon giveaways, it's only going to be running for a few hours after the show ends. You can email makerypixies, with an S, @gmail.com. And the lovely Pixie Nikki, who's now going to have a complete fit that she's going to get about 40 emails. If you message makerypixies@gmail.com, we'll send you the link that way. I'm not going to put it on the Facebook group, and I'm not going to put it on my Facebook page or anything like that, because this is for you guys that are joining in,
that are watching,
and you're helping us out by testing out this giveaway, which apparently isn't going well. I don't think, I don't know why the link isn't working in YouTube, but when we do the giveaways for the events, the link will be on the event page anyway.
Yes.
So this was just a little extra giveaway that we just wanted to sort of test things out, see how things go. So back to the Facebook group. If you are, I've got a button. Some of you may be aware that in the Facebook group, the Makery crew run pups, and pups are pickup projects, and the theme changes every month. We have this month is down on the allotment. Mm-hmm. Here's a selection of images from last month's pup, and that was Pond Life.
Oh, aren't they beautiful?
They are booper fish.
That's so booper sweet. Fish, is there?
Yeah, they're absolutely great. I love them. So, and don't forget, a couple of dates for your diary. Come and join us on May the 1st. We are having a live launch. That'll be on YouTube and Facebook again. Our next show with Hochanda, or sorry, the craft store by Hochanda, is on the 29th of May, and that's on Freeview 85, Freesat 817, and Sky 673. And finally, that date for the 15th of May, and it's Bees Blackmail Make. And in case you couldn't
guess what it might
guess
be.
What it was gonna be.
Literally be.
This is what I've been blackmailed into making. So on the website, pretty much at the end of this broadcast, there is a crafting kit available for next month's crafting. You don't have to have this kit. You are quite welcome to come along and join us. Regardless, you can use your own materials, because everything that we're going to be doing is freehand. But these are called bumblies. Mm-hmm. And they're called bumblies because her grandson can't say bumblebee. He says bumblies. So our
it's
kit
very,
is going
very
to be
cute.
Called...
He's only little. Cute.
He is. What is he? Three?
Four now.
Four.
Yeah, just turned so four.
He says bumblies. So the kit is called Bumblies. It's not under the name Bumblies. You just need to search for Crafternoon kit, and the Bumblies kit will be there. Now, what's in the kit is enough to make two of these little guys. And where is it? It's in there. You do get, I haven't stuck mine on the stick pin yet.
Poor B.
So you do get... the stick pin in there as well. You get two sets of the wings, you get the antennas, and you get the fluff to make your little bumble or your bumblies. There's loads of fluff in the kit to make these things. Now the wings are on acetate. It's a really, really nice kit.
Very cute.
So, but like I said, you don't have to have the kit. The idea with the Crafternoons is that we will occasionally make a kit if it's worthwhile doing. Obviously today there was no kit because, you know, we're blending and just having fun with fibre. So the Bumblies kit will be available on the website soon. Now I've got a little I've got a little game for you, babe.
Oh no. Okay.
I got sent, so this is the silly veg portion of,
I had no idea this was coming, aren't I lucky?
Mm-mm. So basically, I've got some veg in here, and you have to see if you can guess what they are.
Oh, okay.
So here's the. Let me give the. This is the first one. What do you think that one is?
Oh, that's a happy pea.
Very. That's very good. That's very good. It is happy. All right. Next one. Remember Serious Leek?
Yeah.
Okay. Here's this guy. Let me move my stuff out of the way. Check this guy out.
Oh my gosh.
Feel free to guess, people.
Something leek.
Yes, it's definitely something leek. Look what he's got. You look flummoxed. I will tell you, because even I mind you, I didn't get any of them. This is, I was like, it's a policeman leek.
Yeah.
And Sarah was just like, that's just not a thing.
I'm like, okay. Oh,
it's a security leek.
That's clever.
Okay.
It's very good.
Last one, you ready?
That just looks like a ninja carrot.
I said ninja carrot.
That's what it looks like.
That's exactly ninja what carrot. I said it was ninja carrot. It's not.
Oh.
No, we were both completely wrong.
Was he exercising?
It could be. I said it was Rambo carrot. Like, do you want me to tell you?
Karate, it's like karate. Oh, maybe,
you were so close. It's karate.
Yeah. There we go. I was trying to work carrot into that. That's quite good.
So thank you for that. That was ace.
They are fab.
And finally, what I've got here is I've got some... lots of leaves that have been two-toned, and some have stitched veins, and you know, just giving you an idea of, in fact, let me just put this over there, of the sorts of things, you know, for just for a bit of inspiration. Look at these, aren't they gorgeous?
Absolutely.
All Mum's Makery colours. I think this one's lichen and ginger. We've got lichen and evergreen, I think that is.
That's beautiful.
Dark brown, and I think that might be mustard.
I think it is mustard, yeah.
Look at this one.
Oh, look.
So here's some sort of...
See, this goes very well with it. Doesn't it? Just saying.
So there, you know, we've got some, these are the beech leaves, these are oak leaves, obviously we've got the sycamores, we've got the ivy, just some beautiful ways that you can two-tone and blend, and I'm just getting
two-toned absolutely beautifully.
Yeah, you know, I mean, it is,
that was really nice, it's very natural looking.
Yeah, and obviously we do work, you know, ahead of seasons. Say the people who've just got out of Christmas.
So what have they done? Used embroidery floss or cotton?
Yeah. It's embroidery thread. I think it's...
How beautiful.
Three strands, yeah. If you want a nice thick sort of vein.
Very nice.
Vein on it. But, you know, there's a couple of colours that are very, very close together. I think that's cranberry and wine. Really good combo, beautiful combo. So there you go. I think, is that everything? So if you haven't already, then please do go over to our YouTube channel. Please do subscribe to the channel. We do upload new content, new tutorials and stuff. We are still in the process of moving the private tutorials over to hosted service. Service? But I haven't quite had the time to do them all yet. On the website, you will find that there are a couple of links. We have a calendar on the website, which gives you a list of all the up and coming that we are doing. And also it gives you a link to all of the past ones that we've done as well this year, including links to sort of like the various videos and stuff that to go along with it, like the Crafternoons like we're doing here. So I think...
The only thing I can think of is to let them know about Christmas in June.
Oh, yeah. Mm. Skipped right over Christmas, didn't we?
Christmas in June is coming.
It is, and I haven't got a button for it.
Well, that's okay.
I haven't got a button for it.
First Saturday in June.
Yes.
We will be
Christmas
here.
In June, if you don't know. All of the Christmas stuff comes out for 1 month only in June, because it's nice to get ahead and, you know, get a jump on some Christmas crafting. So all of the Christmas projects come out, and all of the new stuff that we're bringing out for Christmas, we do a few new projects as well. We've got some awesome stuff coming. I can't wait. It's really looking forward to it. So that's on the 5th of June. It's an event, so there are two broadcasts, one at 11 a.m. and one at 3 p.m. UK time. There is an event pack, and we have given you the option this time. There are two options for your event pack. There is your standard event pack, which has all of the stuff in it that you need to join in both of the live broadcasts and all of the games, Flingo, a raffle ticket and everything else. You don't need the event pack to join in. There are Pixie giveaways in the Facebook group, and there's all kinds of stuff that you can join in with. The first make of the first broadcast is freehand anyway, And there is a list of materials on the website of what you need to join in with that if you want. The second pack is with extras. And to be honest, everybody's gone for that one.
They have. I don't blame them. It's absolutely amazing.
It is a really, really nice kit. Now, for those of you who do like a little sneaky peek, and I know some of you do, actually, most of them do. They are a bunch of peekers. That's like feeling the Christmas presents.
That's naughty.
No, no, they don't just feel the Christmas presents. They open them up.
They unwrap it and have a peek.
Yeah, we know you're peekers. We know. We know. But if you want a little sneaky peek, then if you go to the product page and scroll down, at the bottom of the description, there is a little link so you can have a look at what's in the bag with and without the extras. So, that, I think, is that. Like I said, there is weights, measures and tutorial lists can all be found on the website. That's mumsmakery.co.uk. Do come over and join the Facebook group. We have a lot of laughs in there, and we do really, really love to see, you know, what you make off of the back of these shows and things as well. So I think that's everything on my list. Is that everything on your list? Technically, we should have the same list.
We have got the same list. Yep, we've told everyone about the Facebook group.
Yeah, we've done all of that. Thank you so much for spending your time with us today. So from me, Pixie B, and all the Makery Pixies and crew, we wish you all a very crafty day. Mm-hmm.